Everybody is watching the merger between Herman Miller and Knoll. Every day there's a new post about what's going on, and it's exciting to see it. But there's something that took place 46 years ago, a publication that may have predicted this very outcome. Here's a little publication that I've kept. I know I've kept it. But it's called A Modern Consciousness, DJ DuPree and Florence Knoll. Let me show you a picture of DJ. And I actually met DJ, I think it was around 1980. He came in and made a cameo visit to the office. His office had a standing Action Office 1 desk. It was a roll-top desk with oak. And I've also met Max DuPree. In fact, I interviewed him for my first book, and he was very gracious. And I had a chance to talk to him a few times since that interview. I've always been fascinated by the cultures of those two companies and the thought leadership. And here we see it coming together. So I thought 46 years ago, 1975, this publication comes out, talks about this common thread of design and thought leadership of these two companies. And here we are seeing them come together. So with that in mind, if you haven't had a chance to listen to the interview with Mark Catchlove with Herman Miller and Mike Petrusky, he does such an awesome job. Mark talks about some of this heritage coming together. He also referenced a book, A Facility Based on Change by Robert Propst, which will be a future post that I will make. If you haven't read it, I think it's a must read for everybody in our industry. You can get it on Amazon. It's a little pricey. It was done in 1968, but it addresses issues that we're dealing with now, such as change and the 8 criteria for dealing with environments of change. So again, very prescient. Great insights from the past are really indicators of what to look for in the future. Stay tuned, and if you found this little piece of history interesting, just let me know. Give me a thumbs up or put a comment, or if you've got some common history that goes back with Herman Miller or Knoll in those early days, I'd love to hear about it.